Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter gene, its nature, expression and regulation. In that we are studying topic the requirements for DNA replication. We all know that DNA replication is the duplication process of DNA. For any experiment, there are certain requirements. So what are the requirements for DNA replication? Let's find out. Requirements for DNA replication. We all know that DNA replication is a process of duplication of DNA, or you can say copies of DNA are made. So for DNA replication, the double-stranded DNA has to form single-stranded DNA. Basically, students, the double-stranded DNA has to form two single strands. So what are the enzymes that will be used to break the double-stranded DNA? The first enzyme is helicases. And when I talk about helicases, it is an enzyme that is used to break the double-stranded helix of DNA. So basically what helicases enzyme does is, it comes first during DNA replication and it disrupts the hydrogen bonds of DNA. Once the hydrogen bonds of DNA are disrupted, what should be the next step? Obviously, all the hydrogen bonds, or you can say all the ATPGC, which is the nitrogen bases, are exposed. So obviously the DNA replication process needs to start. For DNA replication process to start, the next enzyme that comes into picture is primases. So for primases to start the process, what happens is primases will synthesize a primer, which is an oligonucleotide, a single-stranded oligonucleotide. So the function of primases is to synthesize single nucleotide primer. Once the single nucleotide primer is synthesized and attached to the single-stranded RNA, now the next enzyme comes into picture. And this next enzyme is DNA polymerase 3. When I talk about DNA polymerase 3, DNA polymerase 3 basically adds nucleotides, and it will add nucleotide in the direction of 5' to 3'. When I say nucleotide, it means A, T, G, and C. And finally, the last enzyme. We all know that once addition of nucleotides is done and all the nucleotides are at its place, there could be chances that some mistakes could happen in the DNA molecule. And if any type of mistakes happen in DNA molecule, in real life, you can go and check back those mistakes and rectify them. Similarly, there is a mechanism, or there is an enzyme which does proofreading, or simply you can say rectification process. And this enzyme is called as DNA exonucleases. When I say exonucleases, it means it's a nuclease that removes the unwanted nucleotides or the unwanted segments. So once DNA replication is done, DNA exonuclease basically removes the unwanted segment. Requirements for DNA replication process. Now, for DNA replication to take place, there are certain enzymes that are required. The first enzyme that is needed is helicases. When I say helicase, it means an enzyme that breaks the double-stranded helix of DNA. So helicases are the enzymes that help to remove the supercoils, or you can say the tangles in the double-stranded DNA molecule, and it facilitates the unwinding of DNA. Basically, helicases expose the hydrogen bonds of the DNA, or you can say they break the hydrogen bonds, and all the nitrogen bases are alone or they are unpaired because of helicases. Now, once the action of helicases are done, single-stranded DNA can uncoil among themselves. They can form pair. So just to prevent that, we have an enzyme called as SSB, which is single-stranded binding proteins. Now, this single-stranded binding proteins basically prevent rejoining of separate strands. That is, no two separate strands should come to rejoin. That is the reason SSB comes and binds once the function of helicases is done. Lastly, helicases breaks the hydrogen bonds in the DNA and forms the replicating fork. Now, hydrogen bonds in the DNA are the most easiest bonds to break, and they are the ones that can get back together. Once the replicating fork is formed by the action of helicases, there are other enzymes that come into picture. The next enzyme that comes after SSB proteins are primases. Now, primases is an enzyme that synthesizes RNA primer. And now this RNA primer is nothing but a sequence of oligonucleotide, just a single stranded sequence, not the double one. Since DNA polymerase 3, which is the enzyme that adds nucleotides, can only add nucleotide, which is ATGC, to a free 3' OH terminal. So that's the reason first after SSB proteins, RNA primer has to be attached, and then your DNA polymerase 3 can act further. The second last enzyme that comes in DNA replication is DNA polymerase 3. Now when I talk about DNA polymerase 3, it is the enzyme that adds incoming nucleotides, that is ATGC, in the further strand, or you can say in the single stranded DNA, is added with the help of DNA polymerase 3. We all know that if you have to stick a nucleotide to another bond, you need a biological glue. And this biological glue is ligases. So along with ligases and the nucleotides, DNA polymerase 3 tries to fill up the chain and forms a double-stranded DNA. Now once a double-stranded DNA is formed, we all know that there could be some mistakes that can happen in DNA. As a human being, we cannot afford a single mistake in a nucleotide. We all know that students, even if there's a single mistake in a nucleotide, it could lead to a genetic disease or a disorder. Every nucleotide is very crucial and important. So just to avoid that, there's something called as DNA exonucleosis. When I say the word exonucleus, exo means to remove a segment of DNA which is not required. So DNA exonucleases, what they do is they check the incoming nucleotide, and once all the strands are made properly and all the strands or all the nitrogen bases are complementary. When I say complementary, it means A should always pair with T and it should form double bond, whereas G should always pair with C and it should form triple bond. It does professional checking, or in bio language we can say it does proofreading activity, that is cross-checking, and does its function. After that only your DNA replication is completed thoroughly. Students, in this part of the chapter what we did studied was about the enzymes that were used in DNA replication, and those were helicases, SSB proteins, your primases, DNA polymerase 3, and DNA exonucleases. DNA exonucleases are also sometimes called as DNA polymerase 1. I hope you all are clear with this concept of what are the requirements of DNA replication. Thank you.